Welcome to Engineers Academy. Subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to receive the notification for the upcoming videos.
Now we are going to solve this problem 295. So in this problem it is said that as part of a design test, the camshaft drive sprocket is fixed and then the two forces shown are applied to a length of belt wrapped around this sprocket, right? So these are two forces applied. So we need to find the resultant of this system of two forces and determine where its line of action intersects both the x and y axis, right? So we will find the resultant of these two forces and then we will find the line of action of force, the x and y intercept of the line of action of force where it will intersect the x and y axis respectively, right? So we will find it. So now first I will find the Rx component. So Rx will be equal to summation of all forces along x. So now we will first we will resolve these forces into its components, right? So this t2 is making 15 degrees with the vertical and this is making 45 degrees with the vertical, right? So I will resolve this. So if this is the force, let me make it large. So if this is the force, right, so then this will be the cos component, right? And this will be the sine component. Right? And similarly, if I resolve this force into its component, so then this one will be the cos component. And this one will be the sine component. Right? So now the summation of forces along x will give us Rx. So as we can see that this component is 500 sine of 15 degrees, right? And this component is 400 sine of 45 degrees. So these are in the positive x direction. So I will write 500 sine of 15 degrees plus 400 sine of 45 degrees, right? So this will give us Rx. And now if you find Ry, so Ry will be equal to summation of all forces along y. So Ry will be equal to this. So this is the cos component, so it will be 500 cos of 15 degrees plus this one. So this is the 400 cos of 45. So 400 cos of 45 degrees. Right, so this will give us Ry. So if I solve this, so now when we solve this, so Rx comes out to be this and Ry comes out to be this, but as we can see that both the Ry components in the negative y direction, so both of these will be negative, right? So I have written this mistakenly. So these are minus, both in the negative y direction, so this will be minus 765.81, right? So now if you determine the magnitude of R, so it will be equal to Rx square plus Ry square under the root. So R will be equal to, so the magnitude of R comes out to be 869.72 newtons, right? So now we will find the moment about O, right? So the moment about O will be equal to, now as we can see that both the tensions are, both the forces are tangent to this circle, right? So let me remove this. So T1 and T2 both are tangent to this circle, right? So the, so this gear, right? So the radius of this is 60 mm, right? So this 60 mm is the perpendicular distance of both of these forces. So this is point O. So this T2 is producing clockwise moment and this is producing counterclockwise moment. So let's assume that the clockwise moment is positive. So I will write 500 into 60 mm and the other one will be counterclockwise, so it will be minus 400 into 60. So this will give us moment about O. So this is 6000 Newton mm, right? So now if you want to represent these two forces by a force couple system, so what we will do, we will draw a resultant of this magnitude, right? So let me draw it in another free body diagram. So let's suppose if I draw that free body diagram here, So let's suppose if this is the positive x-axis and this is the positive y-axis, and let's assume that this is the pulley. So this is that pulley and this is that point O, right? So what I will do is that I will draw that resultant, right? So if I draw the direction of resultant, so the x component is positive and the y component is negative, right? So this is the x component of R, so this will be Rx, and this is Ry, right? So this will be the direction of R, right? We can find theta, but there is no need to find theta in this problem, right? So we are only asked to find the x and y intercept, so we can only find the direction. So now what I will do, I will represent this R, right? So I will draw a vector R in this direction, right? So this will be that R, right? And I will draw it at this point O. And we will represent that moment as well. Since it is positive, so this means that this is clockwise moment. So I will draw this clockwise moment here. So this is moment about O. So now when we replace these two forces by a force couple system, so we will have this, right? And now if we represent this force couple system by a single force, so what I will do, I will remove this moment and I will find the perpendicular distance of this resultant so that it should produce the exactly this moment, right? So what I will do, I will write R into D is equal to 6000 newton, or I will write that moment about O, right? So moment about O, the magnitude. So I will find D, so it is 6000 newton mm divided by R, so R is 869.72. So this will give us the perpendicular distance of this R, so it will produce this much moment. So this comes out to be 6.90 mm, right? So this is the perpendicular distance of that resultant force, right? So since the dia of this gear is 60 mm, so it will be somewhere here, right? So if I remove this and I will have to move this force in a direction so that it should produce the clockwise moment, and the perpendicular distance of this R should be 6.90 mm, right? So now if I draw a circle of radius this much, 6.90 mm, right? So let me draw another circle. Let's suppose if this is that circle, right? So now what I will do, I will move this R and I will place this R perpendicular to this circle, sorry, tangent to this circle, and it should produce the clockwise moment, right? So now if I place this R here, so it will produce the clockwise moment. So if I place this R at this point, at the opposite point, so then it will produce the counterclockwise moment. So this is the accurate location of this R, right? So now we need to determine the x and y intercept of this, the line of action of this R, right? So we need to determine this point and this point, the line of where the line of action of this force will intersect the x-axis and the y-axis. So let's suppose if this distance is x and this distance is y, so we need to find this x and y length, distances from point O, right? So now if I resolve this force into two components here at this point, right? So this will be the Rx component and this will be the Ry component. So Rx component is passing through point O, so it will not produce moment, so Ry will produce moment. So I will write Ry into x, the perpendicular distance of this Ry from O is x, and this should be equal to moment about O at this particular point. So x will be equal to moment about O is 6000. We will use the magnitude, so 6000 divided by Ry. So Ry is 765.81. So this will give us x in mm. So this comes out to be 7.83 mm, right? And as we can see that this is in the positive x direction, so we will put plus sign here. And similarly, if I resolve this R into its component at this point, at this y-intercept. So this will be Rx and this will be Ry. So Ry will be passing through this point also. In this case, at this y-intercept, Ry will not produce any moment. Only Rx will produce the moment. So we will write Rx, and the perpendicular distance of Rx from O will be Y, and this will be equal to moment about O. So Y will be equal to 6000 divided by Rx. So Rx is 412.25. So Y will be equal to 14.55 mm. And as we can see that this is along the positive y direction, so we will put plus sign here, right? So this is the solution of this problem.